The Bible has many treasures. If you're ready to hear a treasure from the Bible, let me see you click on your listening ears.
Click, click, click.
And you can't forget your special eyes.
Zoop, zoop, zoop.
Now you're ready.
God wanted to be the Israelites' only leader, but they begged him for a king. So God gave them what they asked for. Some of the kings who ruled over them were good, like King David, who loved God and fought for his people. Can you give the good kings a thumbs up for loving and obeying God? Nice! And there was King Josiah, who taught all the people in his kingdom to treasure God's word. But there were also bad kings who did terrible things and who didn't believe in or honor God. Show a thumbs down for that. One of those bad kings was King Ahab. Ahab was evil and did not obey the one true God. But during that time, there was a prophet named Elijah. Can you say Elijah?
Elijah!
Elijah heard special messages from God, and God sent him to tell King Ahab that there would be no rain or dew in the kingdom for the next few years because of Ahab's bad choices. Then, God told Elijah to go and stay near a small stream of water. God promised that Elijah would still have water to drink and that the ravens would bring him food. Can you flap your wings like the ravens? God's words were true. And just like he said, the ravens brought Elijah bread and meat to eat, and he drank water from the stream. When the stream dried up, God spoke to Elijah again and told him to go to a nearby town. There, he would find a woman who would feed him. Elijah obeyed God, and what God said came true. When Elijah entered the town, he found a woman gathering sticks and asked her for a jar of water and a piece of bread. The woman did not have any bread and only a few drops of oil left to make some. She told Elijah she was gathering sticks to make her very last meal for her and her son. Elijah told her not to be afraid. He said to go home and make the meal, but to first make a small loaf of bread for him. He told her that God said she would not run out of ingredients to make bread. The widow went away and did as Elijah told her to do. And Elijah, the widow, and her son had food every day because their ingredients never ran out, just like God had said. What God said to Elijah and the widow was true, and God's word also proved true when he sent Jesus to earth. The people wanted a king, and God promised that he would send them the best king of all, Jesus. Over and over again throughout God's story, we see that what God said would happen really did happen, and that's how we know that God's word is true.
Arr, would you look at that? We got 3 gold doubloons for learning that God's word is true. Now grab your treasure and put it in your pocket.
God's word is true. God's word is true. Repeat after me in your best parrot voice. God's word,
God's word,
is true.
Is true.
Yo-ho, look at you go. We can read God's word and know that it's true.